Good morning, everybody. It's Miss Carol again. I have another exciting Bible story for you, and I hope you like it. It's called The Little Serving Maid. Naaman was the king of Aram's army commander. He had a terrible sickness called leprosy. Naaman knew that if he did not get cured, his strong, beautiful body would become weak, twisted, and ugly. Naaman's wife had a little serving maid. The girl said to his wife, "If Naaman goes to my country to see the prophet Elisha, he will be heard." Naaman told the king what the girl had said. The king said, "Naaman, I am going to write a letter to King Jehoram of Israel, asking him to heal you. Here are some gifts that you can give him in thanksgiving." When King Jehoram received the letter, he thought it was a trick. He said, "The king of Aram knows that there is no cure for Naaman here in Israel. He just wants to start a war." But Elisha, the private prophet, heard that Naaman had sent the letter. And unlike King Jehoram, Elisha knew that there was a cure in Israel. The God of Israel could cure Naaman. Elisha sent for Naaman. When Naaman arrived at Elisha's house, there was only a messenger there. He said, "Elisha told me to tell you, Naaman, to wash 7 times in the River Jordan." Naaman was angry. He said, "Did I come all the way to Israel just to wash in river water? We have better rivers in my country." Naaman thought that it was the water itself that would heal him. And so, furious and disappointed, he started for home. But before leaving, one of Naaman's manservants said, "Why don't you just do what Elisha says? It won't hurt just to try." Naaman did not know what to do. He said, "Well, it is obedient and faithful to follow what the God of Israel says. And if he says that it will cure him, well, let's give it a try." When Naaman came out of the river, he was healed. He returned to Elisha, saying that there was no other God except the God of Israel. Elisha knew that it was God who healed Naaman. He, therefore, would not accept Naaman's gifts. God used the little serving maid to cure Naaman and to bring others to know, love, and serve him as the one true God. And that's the story of the little servant girl who helped a man get rid of his horrible health problem called leprosy. And that's the end of our story for today. I hope you enjoyed it.